A who owes 10 B rupees 10,000 appoints B as agent. So first he owes the money, then he appoints B as his agent to sell his land property at Delhi, and after paying himself B what is due to him, hand over the balance to A. Can A revoke his authority? This is, my dear friends, as simple as it gets. It is section 202. Section 202, case of agency coupled with interest. Right? This agency coupled with interest. Can A revoke authority delegated to B? The answer is a big no. Right. Sunil borrowed a sum of rupees 3 lakh from Rajendra. Sunil appointed Rajendra as his agent to sell his land and authorized him to appropriate the amount of loan out of the sale proceeds. Afterwards, Sunil revoked agency. Sunil appointed Rajendra. So Sunil becomes who? The principal appointed Rajendra agent. Right. Lekin borrowed amount was done before, on or before the date of contract. ठीक है. आफ्टरवर्ड सुनील रिवोक द एजेंसी, डिसाइड ऑन प्रोविजंस. सबसे पहले वेदर द रिवोकेशन ऑफ सेड एजेंसी बाय सुनील इज लॉफुल. नो, देयर कैन नॉट बी एनी रिवोकेशन. सेम सेक्शन 202, एजेंसी कपल्ड विद इंटरेस्ट एंड द इंटरेस्ट वाज क्रिएटेड एट और बिफोर द टाइम ऑफ फॉर्मेशन ऑफ द कॉन्ट्रैक्ट. राइट. यहाँ प्रॉपर्टी बिकेगी, उसमें से पैसा रखा जाएगा. द मनी वुड बी केप्ट बाई द एजेंट एंड देन द रेस्ट ऑफ द अमाउंट वुड बी रिपैट्रिएटेड टू द प्रिंसिपल. राइट. सो एज पर सेक्शन 202, देयर इज एजेंसी कपल्ड विद इंटरेस्ट एंड देयर कैन नॉट बी एनी कैंसलेशन ऑफ सच काइंड ऑफ एजेंसी. सो दैट सॉर्ट्स आर क्वेश्चन नंबर 15 एंड 16. जस्ट इमेजिन, 5 मार्क्स फॉर दिस. दिस इज सुपर सिंपल. स्मार्ट वर्सेस सैंडर्स इज द केस इन पॉइंट दैट यू नीड टू रिकलेक्ट. राइट. वहां हमने क्या पढ़ा था? दैट इट वॉज आफ्टर आफ्टर द यू कैन से द कॉन्ट्रैक्ट ऑफ एजेंसी दैट देर वॉज एनी सब्सिक्वेंट ट्रांजेक्शन रिगार्डिंग लोन्स एंड बोरिंग्स एंड हेंस देर वॉज नो एजेंसी कपल्ड विद इंटरेस्ट. राइट. और बाद में हमने एक सूर्य नारायण वर्सेज भूषे यावर भी मैंने कोट किया था. वेन देर वॉज एजेंसी कपल्ड विद इंटरेस्ट इट वॉज बिफोर द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ द कॉन्ट्रैक्ट दैट सच इंटरेस्ट डिड अराइज. राइट. That's why we say at the time. So when the contract has been entered into, is there an interest in favor of the agent that has been there in the contract? If we notice 15 and 16, yes, at the time of formation of the contract, there is an interest that is created in favor of the agent. Right. Now let's start moving forward ahead. Right. Now coming on to question number 17, comment on the following principle is not always bound by the acts of a sub agent. Right. देखो ये क्वेश्चन नंबर 17 और 18 साथ में ही लेते हैं. ब्रीफली एक्सप्लेन द पोजीशंस ऑफ सब एजेंट एंड सब्स्टिट्यूटेड एजेंट अंडर द लॉ ऑफ एजेंसी. नाउ फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, फॉर डूइंग क्वेश्चन नंबर 17, प्रिंसिपल इज नॉट ऑलवेज बाउंड बाय द एक्ट्स ऑफ सब एजेंट. यू हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट एंड हु इज अ सब एजेंट. राइट. तो पहले हमको You have to understand sub-agent and substituted agent, the difference between the two. Right. So we'll start with section 190 on sub-agency. Section 190. सबसे पहले 190 समझ लेते हैं. क्या बोलता है 190? लिखते हैं एन एजेंट कैन नॉट लॉफुली एम्प्लॉय अनदर. एंड lawfully employ अनदर फॉर वॉट टू परफॉर्म एक्ट्स विच ही हैज अंडरटेकन टू परफॉर्म परफॉर्म एक्ट्स विच ही हैज अंडरटेकन टू परफॉर्म. Certain exceptions to this, right? Now, इसका मतलब क्या होता है? This means a delegatee cannot further delegate. वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट स्टेटमेंट. अ डेलीगेटी फर्दर के नॉट डेलीगेट, यानी इफ अ जॉब हैज बीन एंट्रस्टेड टू समवन ही कैनॉट फर्दर डेलीगेटेड. सो मीन्स एन एजेंट कैनॉट अपॉइंट अ पर्सन हु वुड बी वर्किंग अंडर हिम डूइंग अ पार्ट ऑफ हिज जॉब, राइट. सो इसको हम लोग बोलते हैं द बेसिक रूल. देखो, द आइडिया ऑफ एजेंसी इज बेस्ड ऑन म्यूचुअल ट्रस्ट. इफ आई ट्रस्ट यू, आई गिव यू द वर्क. And you again appoint and give that work or a part of that work to somebody else. So over here, the relationship of trust is not established. If I think that somebody else is better off, I'll give him the work. Why I should give you the work, right? So the person employed and who acts, ab samajhte hain. Acha, ye maine bola exceptions bhi yahan possible honge. Let me tell you that. So general rule is a delegatee further cannot delegate, but there are exceptions, right? So when a person is employed by, when a person is employed by whom? By the agent, and acts under the control of the original agent. In the business of agency, then such a person is termed as sub-agent, right? Now, over here, ये हमारा cover होता है section 191 में. पहले 190 में क्या बोला है? That a delegatee further cannot delegate. So if I have given you work, you cannot delegate it further to anybody else, right? If I say I have a plot of land in Kormangla and you have to sell it, you are my agent. You cannot further entrust the job to somebody else. So when a person is employed, like in 191 theek ulta bol raha hai, when a person is employed by and acts under the control of the original agent in the business of agency, then such a person is termed as sub agent. Kuch sub agent mein do tarah ke appointment hote hain, right? Two types of appointment. One is termed as प्रॉपर अपॉइंटमेंट एंड इम्प्रॉपर अपॉइंटमेंट, राइट? इज प्रॉपर अपॉइंटमेंट एंड देन देयर इज इम्प्रॉपर अपॉइंटमेंट. सी इफ देयर इज प्रॉपर अपॉइंटमेंट एंड इफ देयर इज इम्प्रॉपर अपॉइंटमेंट व्हाट आर द फॉलोआउट्स. बहुत लंबा टॉपिक है ये, आई नॉट गो इन टू दैट डेप्थ फॉर प्रॉपर एंड इम्प्रॉपर अपॉइंटमेंट. First, we have to understand what is a proper appointment, and then we have to understand what is improper appointment. If there is proper appointment, one important thing you have to remember, then the principle would be liable to third parties, right? So if there is a proper appointment, the principal is liable to the third parties, whereas if there is improper appointment, the principal is not liable to third parties. Now, who is liable to third party? Agent, original agent is liable to third party, right? एक बार हम लोग इसका tree समझ लेते हैं. See, principal, agent, sub-agent. That is how the tree of control works. So there we have principal, then we have agent, then we have sub agent, right? Right. So the principal is one who holds the power, right? He directs the agent, gives entrusts him some job, and the agent further directs the sub agent to do the job or a part of the job, right? This is how the tree of power works over here. So who appoints the sub agent? The agent appoints the sub agent. Keep that in mind, right? Now first we'll go into the nitty-gritties. Ye do sabse important part hai. Proper appointment, the principal would be liable to the third parties for the act of the sub agent. Improper appointment, the principal is not liable. Kaun liable hai bhai? Agent, right? So first we have to understand the conditions of proper appointment. Acha, improper appointment kya hota hai? Whenever the appointment is not proper, it is improper. Seedha hisab hai, right? So if we learn the conditions of proper appointment, we can figure out easily what is improper appointment. So conditions under which appointment is considered proper, right? Conditions under which the appointment is considered a proper appointment, right? अगर जो ये कंडीशन में नहीं फिट हो रहा है, देन इट इज इम्प्रॉपर अपॉइंटमेंट. एज सिंपल एज दैट, राइट? सो फर्स्ट थिंग, फर्स्ट इंस्टेंस, प्रिंसिपल हैज एक्सप्रेसली परमिटेड the appointment of the sub-agent right when the principal has expressly appointed the expressly permitted the appointment of the sub agent, right? एक एग्जाम्पल ले लेते हैं जल्दी जल्दी. लेट अस से सर इज द ओनर ऑफ अ ज्वेलरी शोरूम. पता नहीं क्या तो रीड कर रहा है. Owner of jewelry showroom. Among other businesses, I have this business. बहुत सारा पैसा है मेरे पास. Assume, right? Now there is one manager at the showroom whose name is Yash. Manages the entire showroom, right? Now, Yash has so much of work. He has to deal with cash. He has to do buying of gold, selling of gold, customer relation, right? So there is too much of work. Now, Yash has been told by sir, "Bhai, kaam bahut zyada hai. So why don't you appoint someone?" So he appoints one Mr. Shanmugam under him. Now Shanmugam handles the selling part of the job, right? So he manages the customer relation and selling part under the job, and that is what he has been appointed for. So over here, sir has expressly asked Yash to appoint someone under him who would be reporting to Yash, and then Yash would be reporting to me. So Shanmugam turns to be sub agent, and Yash turns up to be the agent. Right, so this is how it works. This is termed as expressly permitted the appointment of the sub agent. Right, now point number two. So the first appointment is termed as proper appointment. Right, second, when the principal impliedly allows the delegation of work. Delegation of work. ठीक है. Same case मान लो कि I'm pretty sure none of the whiteboard apps work without struggle, right? So there's sir, there's Mr. Yash, same story. I'm the owner of a jewelry shop, right? I'm the owner of a jewelry shop, and Yash, without asking me, has appointed one Mr. Shanmugam. Yash, without asking me, has appointed one Mr. Shanmugam as the person who is managing the cash. Right? I visit the shop. I have to collect the weekly amount of revenues, right? And the totals. So I go to the shop, and Yash says, "Sir, Shanmugam will explain everything and he'll hand over the cash to you." And I have not seen this guy before, and he is managing everything, cash and stuff. Most important part of the story, right, for any businessman. So I do not interfere and I do not say that Yash, why you have appointed and stuff. I just go there, he gives me the cash, hands over the cash, explains the accounts to me for the week, how the sales have been and stuff, right? So over here, my answer is pretty simple. I know the fact that Mr. Shanmugam has been appointed, he is managing cash, he is doing the totals and giving the cash to me. I have not interfered with the process and I have not raised any questions on that one. So, if I am receiving the money from him and Shanmugam is explaining cash to me, great. And I do not interfere with the process, it is nothing but impliedly allowing, right? Is like an implied acceptance of mine for the appointment of the sub-agent. This is again termed as a proper appointment, right? Now, third one, when there is custom and usage of trade to the same effect. Right. So we had done an example of stock market yesterday. Right. Sir ko ek account khulana hai. Right. He goes to XYZ broking house, right? So generally we have witnessed, for people who are aware of the stock markets and brokers and how they work, there are always, these brokers are nothing but agents, they're always appointment of sub brokers. Let me tell you that whenever you go and open an account with any of the broking houses, right, there are a lot of them, Motilal Oswal, Angel Broking, right, Anand Rathi Services, these are big, big broking houses, Kavi Consultants. Now, Zerodha is an online platform, so that directly connects you. But when I'm talking about the yesteryears, the idea was very, very common because one broker wouldn't be able to physically meet and communicate with so many clients, right? In that case, the agency was given to lot many brokers and these brokers directly connected with the clients. So there is a custom and usage of trade wherein these sub brokers are appointed and they directly connect with the client, right? So whenever you open an account with any of the broking houses, you are technically dealing with the sub broker over there, and this is something customary of stock market business. So there is a custom and usage of trade to the same effect, right? So ye ho gaya hamara custom and usage ka one of the best examples. Now coming to another proper appointment, when the nature of the work is menial, right? When the job doesn't require any kind of specific skills and stuff, right? We call it a menial job. For example, sir is doing some construction work, so there is a lot of garbage, so removal of garbage. So removal of garbage is something which is a work which does not require a lot of skills and knowledge, right? So removal of garbage is the work, and sir is appointed one Mr. Raghavendra. for removal of garbage. Raghavendra further outsources the work to one Mr. Yash. Right. So over here, what do we witness? That appointment of Yash as the sub-agent is a proper appointment, yes, because the nature of the work is such which does not require any kind of special skill or knowledge. That is again a proper appointment. Another one, proper appointment is appointment in case of necessaries. Right. This is one of the most simple things to learn. Let us say sir wanted to send apples to Mumbai, right, to be appointed Ishika, the truck driver, right, transport person, to take the apples, right. Midway in the journey, Ishika's truck was broken, right, so the truck couldn't move ahead, so there was a breakdown. Right, so Ishika appointed Priyal, another truck driver, midway to take the apples to Mumbai. So over here, the appointment of Priyal is nothing but appointment of a sub-agent in case of necessary, zarurat padne pe, emergency aa gaya hai, right? So over here, the appointment is termed as a proper appointment. Right? The appointment is termed as a proper appointment. Right? So that is another instance of proper appointment. Now, when, see, at times the agent may be given a work which is not his core, right? So when the nature of agency necessitates the delegation of work. अब ये क्या है भाई? जैसे मैंने बताया, at times the agent is appointed and given some work which is not his core, and that's why the nature of the work is such that if you do not appoint sub agent, you cannot complete the work because तुमको तो आता नहीं है वो. Right. Let us take this real life example. Sir of Bangalore has a house in Mussoorie or Nainital, right? Now there is one bank that sir knows, he has an account over there and he has a house. Right. So sir has a house in Nainital. Now sir wants to give this house on rent, and sir appoints bank for the purpose. अच्छा, bank का क्या ये कोई core काम है? That is this bank's job to find customers and gives the house on rent? The answer is no. This is not bank's competency, right? This is not bank's competency to find customers for house, right? So the bank appoints another person, right? Gone by Hemant. bank appoints Hemant to find a customer and put the house on rent. Over here, is the appointment proper? Yes, the answer is very much it is a proper appointment, because the nature of agency, yani the work that I have given to bank, necessitates the delegation of work. Right? Without delegation, ye kaam ho hi nahi sakte. Bank ka kaam hi nahi hai sabse pehle yaar. Theek hai? So this is again an instance of proper appointment of sub agent. Right. So let us scroll through very quickly. Where have we come? Right. तो यहाँ क्या पूछा था, कमेंट ऑन द फॉलोइंग क्वेश्चन नंबर 17 में, प्रिंसिपल इज नॉट ऑलवेज बाउंड बाय द एक्ट्स ऑफ द सब एजेंट. अभी आधा ही क्वेश्चन हुआ है. राइट, सो एन एजेंट कैन नॉट लॉफुली एम्प्लॉय अनदर टू परफॉर्म हिज वर्क, यानी अ डेलीगेट ही फर्दर कैन नॉट डेलीगेट. सो व्हाट वी लर्नड, अपॉइंटमेंट कैन हैपन एंड दैट कैन प्रॉपरली बाइंड द प्रिंसिपल सब्जेक्ट टू इट बीइंग अ प्रॉपर अपॉइंटमेंट. पहले हमने क्या समझा, प्रॉपर अपॉइंटमेंट के सारे पार्ट समझ लिए. और क्वेश्चन में हमसे क्या पूछा है यहाँ, प्रिंसिपल इज नॉट ऑलवेज बाउंड बाय द एक्ट्स ऑफ द सब एजेंट. ये प्रॉपर अपॉइंटमेंट का लिस्ट बना लिया. राइट, एक्सप्रेस अथॉरिटी, इम्प्लाइडली, कस्टम एंड यूसेज ऑफ ट्रेड, व्हेन द जॉब इज मीनियल इन नेचर, एंड द अपॉइंटमेंट इन केस ऑफ नेसेसरीज, एंड लास्ट इज व्हेन द नेचर ऑफ द वर्क हैंडेड ओवर टू द एजेंट इज सच दैट without appointment of sub agent he cannot go ahead. So last आपको conclude कैसे करना है, यही पूरा list लिखना है. उसके बाद लिखना है the principle is not bound. अभी हमने सीखा था क्या भाई, याद करो, the principle is not bound by the acts of the sub agent if the appointment is not proper. Right? If the appointment is not proper. एक छोटा सा एग्जाम्पल लेकर कंक्लूड करना चाहूंगा. आई विल गिव यू एन आइडिया ऑफ प्रॉपर एंड इम्प्रॉपर अपॉइंटमेंट. सी, सर वांट्स टू सेल अ प्लॉट ऑफ लैंड. राइट, राइट, सर वांट्स टू सेल अ प्लॉट ऑफ लैंड. ही अपॉइंट्स वन मिस्टर यश. राइट, तो यहां अगर देखो रियल एस्टेट ब्रोकिंग में सब एजेंट का कोई सिस्टम नहीं है. इफ इट इज देयर देन इट हैज टू बी बट डन विद ड्यू परमिशन, आइदर एक्सप्रेस इम्प्लाइड ऑफ द प्रिंसिपल. राइट, बिकॉज इट इज अगेन अ गेम ऑफ स्किल, इट्स नॉट अ मीनियल वर्क. राइट, सो आई वांट टू सेल अ प्लॉट ऑफ लैंड, आई वुड रिक्वायर अ प्रॉपर पर्सन टू नेगोशिएट एंड फाइंड द कस्टमर्स फॉर मी. सो यश, विदाउट मी asking him to expressly appoint a sub agent without me impliedly agreeing to that one, right, Yash appoints one guy, let us say Anand. Right, as the sub agent. Now Anand takes an advance from third party because I want to sell the property. So he takes an advance from third party. Over here, this is an improper appointment. Neither have expressly agreed, neither have impliedly agreed, neither it is in the custom and usage of trade, neither the work is menial in nature, neither the agency requires, it necessitates the appointment of a sub agent. Kuch nahi. To ye ho gaya hamara appointment kaisa bhai? Improper. So, if the appointment is improper, is the principal liable to the third party for the acts of the sub-agent? Right? The answer is no. The principal is not liable to third party. So, if the third party comes and says to sir that I have paid certain advance money, I say to whom you have paid, I have no clue. Right? And आई एम नॉट रिस्पॉन्सिबल, सो हु हैड अपॉइंटेड हिम, अवर मिस्टर इंटेलिजेंट यश हैज अपॉइंटेड हिम, सो इज यश रिस्पॉन्सिबल, द आंसर इज यस, फॉर द एक्ट्स ऑफ द सब एजेंट, द एजेंट इज रिस्पॉन्सिबल. तो हियर इफ द पूरा लिस्ट आपको आंसर कैसे करना है, पहले लिखना है सब एजेंसी के ऊपर, फिर केसेस ऑफ प्रॉपर एंड इम्प्रॉपर अपॉइंटमेंट एज टू व्हाट इज द आउटकम, देन प्रॉपर अपॉइंटमेंट किस किस कंडीशंस में है, उसके बाद कंक्लूड करना है द प्रिंसिपल इज नॉट बाउंड बाय द एक्ट्स ऑफ द सब एजेंट इफ द अपॉइंटमेंट ऑफ द सब एजेंट इज इम्प्रॉपर इन नेचर, अ केस इन पॉइंट ओवर हियर वेर इट डजंट फिट्स इन टू प्रॉपर अपॉइंटमेंट एनी ऑफ द क्राइटेरियाज ऑफ प्रॉपर अपॉइंटमेंट. हेंस Mr. Sir is not, hence Mr. Sir is not responsible for the acts of the sub-agent, right?